In this video, we'll be looking at measurements by reviewing the units of different metric measurements for length, weight, and capacity. Then we'll be looking at converting between different units of measurement within each of those categories. We'll also be looking at estimating by using some sort of known measurement, and then finally converting between different units of time. Here we have a chart of the three different types of metric measurements: length, weight, and capacity. Each of these has a base measurement. So for length, we use a base measurement of meters. For weight, we use a base measurement of grams. And for capacity, or the space inside an object, we use the base measurement of liters. One of the great things about the metric system is it's so easy to convert between different units within each of these types of measurement. For each of these types of measurements, we're going to use milli to represent a thousandth, centi to represent a hundredth of the base measurement, and kilo to represent a thousand of the base measurement. So we can write in the abbreviation for millimeters, centimeters, and kilometers for length. For weight, we're going to use the same prefixes, and we'll get milligrams, centigrams, and kilograms. And for capacity, we'll have milliliters, centiliters, and kiloliters. We already have one measurement here for length, which is 1,250 millimeters. So let's convert this into centimeters. So to do that, we divide it by 10. We do this because there's 10 millimeters in a centimeter. I can then convert this into meters by dividing by 100 to get 1.25, because there's 100 centimeters in a meter. I can then convert it into kilometers by dividing it by 1,000, because there are 1,000 meters in a kilometer. This gives us 0.00125 kilometers. I can double check this by converting them back again. If I multiply it by 1,000, it gives us 1.25 meters. If I multiply that by 100, it gives us 125 centimeters. And if I multiply that by 10, it gives us 1,250 millimeters. We can also apply this to weight and capacity, as we'll see here. We start with 480 grams. Divide it by 1,000 to get 0.48 kilograms. Obviously, if I times it by 1,000, I'm going to get 480 grams. Times it by 100 to get 48,000 centigrams, and multiply it by 10 to get 480,000 milligrams. To complete the circle, we could divide it by 10 and then divide it by 100 to get back to 480 grams. For capacity, if we start with 175 centiliters, again, we can divide this by 100 to get 1.75 liters, divide that by 1,000 to get 0.00175 kiloliters. To go back the other way, times by 1,000 to get 1.75 liters, and then times by 100 to get 175 centiliters. Then times it by 10 to get 1,750 milliliters, and we can divide by 10, and we're back to where we started. Remember that when we're converting from a smaller unit of measurement to a larger one, we divide, as you'll need less units, and vice versa for the other way around, we'll have to multiply. Next, we have some conversion problems. To convert from 1.2 meters to centimeters, we need to multiply by 100, as there's 100 centimeters in a meter, and I'm moving from a larger measurement to a smaller one. So I multiply by 100, 1.2 times 100 to give us 120 centimeters. To convert from kilograms to grams, as I'm moving from a larger measurement to a smaller one, I'm going to multiply. And there's 1,000 grams in a kilo. So 3.4 times 1,000 gives us 3,400 grams. Next, I'm going to convert from 1,265 millimeters to meters. As this jumps from millimeters straight to meters, I'm going to convert it into centimeters first by dividing by 10 to get 126.5 centimeters. And then divide by 100 to get 1.265 meters. We can convert this straight from millimeters to meters by dividing by 1,000, as 10 times 100 equals 1,000. This will also give us the answer of 1.265 meters. In the last one, I'm going to convert from 2.5 liters to milliliters. I'm going to multiply by 100 to get 240 centiliters, and then multiply by 10 to get 2,500 milliliters. Again, we could multiply by 1,000 to move straight from liters to milliliters. In this question, we're told that the bus and the man are drawn to the same scale. We're asked to estimate the height of the bus. The key word in this problem is the word estimate, which means we can round any number to one significant figure. If the measurement they would like us to use is metres, and we know that the average man is closer to 2 metres than 1 metre, we'll use that as our known measurement. We can see by scaling this up that the bus is roughly 2.5 times the height of the man. So we can state that the bus is 2 times 2.5, which equals 5 metres tall. This type of question comes up quite often on the Foundation GCSE papers, and it's a skill that you'll actually use in real life as well as the exam. Estimation is a mathematical process which allows for a visual idea of size when describing objects. Whereas metric units have a simple conversion process, time uses many differing units and multipliers, as you can see here. Because there's 60 seconds in a minute, 60 minutes in an hour, 24 hours in the day, 7 days in a week, 14 days in a fortnight, and 52 weeks in the year. Very often, it's handy to be able to convert between these units. In order to do so, you're going to have to understand whether you're going from a smaller unit of measurement to a large one, in order to decide whether you need to multiply or divide. If you're going from smaller units to larger one, you'll have to be dividing and multiplying for the reverse direction. To convert from 300 minutes into hours, I'm going from a smaller unit of measurement to a larger one, so I'm going to divide 300 by 60. It's going to give us 5 hours. To convert 72 hours to days, again, I'm going to go from a smaller measurement to a larger one, so I'll be dividing. As there are 24 hours in a day, I'll do 72 divided by 24 to give us 3 days. Next, we're asked what 4 minutes is as seconds. Here, I'm going from a larger measurement to a smaller one. There's 60 seconds in a minute, so I'll do 4 times 60, which will give us 240 seconds. What is half a year in weeks? In total, there's 52 weeks in a year, and I want half of that. So I'm going to do 52 divided by 2, which equals 26. A very useful skill to have, especially when dealing with speed, distance, and time, is to be able to convert minutes into a decimal of hours. For instance, 2 hours and 30 minutes. As there are 60 minutes in an hour, the 30 minutes would be written as 30 over 60, and therefore be half or 0.5. So we can say this equals 2.5 or 2.5 hours. Let's consider what 30 minutes is in hours. If we make it into a fraction, it's 30 over 60, which is half an hour or 0.5 hours. 15 minutes in hours is going to be 15 over 60, which equals a quarter or 0.25 hours. 45 minutes in hours is going to be 45 over 60, which can be simplified to 3 over 4 and therefore equal 0.75 hours. We can also use this for units of 6 minutes as well, as 6 minutes over 60 will give us 1 over 10 or 0.1 hours. 12 minutes would be 0.2, 18 minutes would be 0.3, and so on. In this video, we looked at reviewing the units of metric measurements, remembering that milli stands for thousandth, centi stands for hundredth, and kilo stands for thousand of the base unit. We converted between different units of measurement, and we estimated height using scale, and then looked at converting between different units of time. In the next video, we'll be looking at how to calculate the perimeter and area of different shapes, including compound shapes. I'll see you then.